Good morning, Sagittarius. Good morning. You see, I always have these turquoise beads out and just, I don't usually show them, but I just wanted to tell you, Sag, that turquoise is very good for Sagittarius. It is for protection, for meditation. For even boosting your energy, Sag. Very good. So I just wanted to start though. Someone has said to me that since the channel is getting bigger, that it might be a good idea for me to open myself up to work with brands. So I'm going to be including a business email in the description. For business inquiries only. I don't talk more. I'm not going to email more about the readings. So if you are looking to have something promoted and I can help you out and we can work together, you can contact me through that email. I'm particularly interested in like custom decks and everything because I love them, especially Oracle decks. So I wanted to put that FYI out there, and that could be anything. That could be, some sort of product that helps anyone. It doesn't have to be just about tarot cards, could even be channels. Just, hit me up and let me know. And on my podcast, I am going to start talking about tarot there too, especially for those who may be starting out. I'm not giving classes on tarot, but different things in my tarot journey that were helpful. Okay, and maybe it will help you too. And don't mind the noise, it's trash day, y'all. The dogs are going crazy. And also, I'm going to start doing this thing on Friday called Friday Favorites, where I'm going to focus on some of my favorite things, things that have helped me from books to products, because, to be honest, spiritual journey sometimes, there are tools, y'all. There are tools. So first of all is well, Sag. All is well. And can we talk? Because I feel like Sagittarius, you are very much feeling the Aries energy. Yeah, I think you are. I think Sagittarius is really feeling the Mercury retrograde energy. Because, what's different about this Mercury retrograde is that it's a lot about healing. And a lot about healing the self because the energetic vibration today is the solar plexus chakra. And I feel okay, so this the solar plexus is chakra is like your stomach right underneath your belly button. And so, when there's a need to work with that, sometimes you can actually like if you're experiencing issues with your stomach, particularly, stomach pains or your stomach's been bothering you, that can be a hint to you that something is out of balance. But this is all about your sense of self, okay? And it is relating to the energies of the day, Sag, let me just say that. The frequency of the solar plexus chakra, the yellow flower of life, supports our sense of self, our personal power, our willpower, as well as our knowing of who we are and what our contribution is on the whole, right? So I have felt in the last few days like Sagittarius really needs to keep their health in mind. I said what I said. Specifically, you may want to really pay attention to your digestive health, Sagittarius. It is kind of a little known fact that a lot of Sagittarians can have digestive issues. I do. I have my whole life I have, Right. And when you're stressed out, that can definitely happen and can be kind of a sign to you too, whether or not you're strong in your own power. Yeah, I know it's crazy. It's crazy, and it's all over, what you're receiving is this is kind of yours is like kind of like the strength card, but it's about your vitality. And there's so much here about your vitality. And I'm going to be honest, it's because of something that's coming in possibly for you, but overall, it's about doing what's good for you. It's about knowing yourself and knowing what's good for you. And because Cougar is here, you have come into your own power. Now is the time to take the lead in this situation and be strong. Using the power of intentions, be clear with your purpose and define where you are heading. So you're definitely coming into this energy where this may, you may feel like in everything you do, it's like your first, well, it's like being devoted to yourself first. It's considering yourself first and your own personal heart health. So yeah. And how this is relating to what may be going on or what wants to be told to you today is that you're gonna really need to consider and really know what's good for you, Sagittarius, because it does feel like there's a decision coming up. Now, I feel like this is someone, this does involve other people. Right, but it's like there's a decision that needs to be made. It could be that the powers that be want you to make this decision quickly, and this could be stressing you out. This could be stressing you out because, the 11th house is here, which is really about our groups of people, right? It could be our friend groups, our work groups, our social groups. But it's also Aquarius energy, which is that think outside the box energy. And also it's the consideration of other people. So this decision is not, I mean, to be taken lightly, and I feel like it might cause a conflict, like even a fight, Sag, because there clearly is someone here who wants you to make a decision quickly and you don't. You don't want to because it could be that you want more information, but there are things for you to consider, such as your own security here. It's fourth house energy, could have to do with family. But I feel like this could cause an argument. It could be about help because this is charity, right? Yeah. So, people affecting your day, Sagittarius. I'm going to look more deeply at this decision that's coming up, but I feel like it could cause a problem. I feel like it could cause an argument. And, because like you want to do what's best for you. Okay. But there's also this energy of what's best for everyone. So it's not, I don't feel, I feel like for you, it's not a decision to be made lightly, right? So, people affecting your day. Now, has kids is here. So, this could be that your own children are affecting your day, or, it could be that this person that's wanting you to make this decision has children. Aggressive. Extrovert and light hair or eyes. So, once again, there's so much Aries energy here, but this person is being very aggressive and, they could have light hair or eyes. So, divorce is here with distance, health, and no. I feel like it does feel like you're not making this decision because this is not a decision that, you know that it's not the right time to make a decision and that's what's best for you. Okay, so you know that what's best is that you kind of pull yourself away from this person who wants you to make the decision. You need some time to think. I need to step back and I feel like one thing that you're saying is that it's not the right time for this decision, which that's very interesting, Sagittarius. Now, Earth sign is here with commitment, let go. There seems to be a lot of people in the mix on this, and maybe that's the point. It's like there isn't just you, there's other people to be considered, you know? And you want to really take these things into account before you commit to anything. It makes sense to me, Sag. So we're gonna take a deeper look with the tarot at this decision. Yes. Okay, Sagittarius. Like you're showing up as the Queen of Pentacles, which is, you know, the Queen of Pentacles, it's like usually, and maybe specifically with this person, you tend to do what they want, you know, and think about everyone else's wishes because, and I feel like this is why this is such like a weighty decision because there isn't just you to consider, you know, and you have to really think about your stability. There's something here in terms of your own security that is involved, right? This may have to do with a job, Sag. The Eight of Pentacles is here. So, you know, and I kind of feel, I don't know why, but it just feels like your health is involved too. Like it feels like that's part of the decision. Like, would this be good for you? It is basically, you know, what you're, you know, because this is a big change with judgment. You know, judgment is the need to make the decision, but also people don't make quick decisions with judgment and the Queen of Pentacles. That's not a quick decision, Sag. That's a looking at all the details, you know, looking back. I mean, because I feel like this is a big, would be a big life change for you. And so, I mean, there's a lot to consider. And I feel like the argument comes in because this person, whoever this is, they're not looking at everything because they're coming at it from a page point of view. You know, and that's immature, that's impulsive, that's, you know, and you're not. You're coming at it from a queen point of view. And so, like with the Page of Pentacles, what this choice is about, the Page of Pentacles and the Page of Cups, it feels like it's an opportunity, Sag. May even be a job, right? But it's in its infancy state, and that's the thing. You know, right now, it's just an idea. It's not even. You know, and it's an idea that someone clearly wants you to invest in, and you do really kind of like it. You know, with the Page of Cups, you do. The Page of Pentacles, but with the Page of Pentacles, we're also wanting to learn more. Right? I feel like you do really love this idea because there are cups here saying that, but I just feel like you feel. Like, well, you know, wait a second, because there's a lot to consider here. I can't just jump into something, even though it seems like a really great idea. I can't just jump in without a lot of consideration because there isn't just me to consider. You know, and that is like one of the things that is, you know, going on. Now, idealism is here. And here's the thing. You know, the thing with Aquarius energy is like, this could be something very different than what you're used to. But it's also like, Aquarius tends to see the future. You know, there's something very innovative about this, very new. And I feel like you feel like this person is very idealistic, you know, and it just seems like, you know, there's so much that they haven't considered that you need to. And basically, you know, first of all, with the magician, you know, and the Queen of Cups, I mean, the Queen of Cups says, I want to do what's best for me, you know, and trying to figure out if this could work for you. You know, and it seems like this other person isn't. I mean, they're coming at it from an idealistic view, to be honest. Very much feels like there's so much Aries energy. Oh my gosh. You know, and I feel like with you, it's like you're really ready for a change, right? Really ready for a change. Maybe have been feeling pretty restless. But you also, like, I just keep coming back to, there's just not you to think about. You know, and wow, Virgo energy. It's like, does this make sense? Can you put into this? It's interesting. Because, you know, in terms of this decision and what causes this argument, this is exactly what you're telling this person. I have a lot to think about, more to think about, more people to, you know, like the health of my family, the Ten of Cups, you know, because there is a sense here that you are responsible for others. Okay. So, you know, because it does feel as if you're trying to make the best decision for everyone, you know, because with the King of Wands, and the King of Wands is a leader, and it's also like, before the King of Wands acts, he knows it all. You know, he knows all the variables, and, you know, it's like you have to feel positive about this and about that it could turn out good for you and for everyone involved. Now, if that is people that you have to take care of, or it is all the people involved with this opportunity, this is the mindset that you're coming from, you know, and it could be that in this way, you need to take control because this person is coming at it from a page point of view, you know, and when it's pages, it's a beginning, you know, it's pages are initiation. So it's like, this person has an idea and it's a good one, but they have not considered everything. And I feel like we've seen this energy before in a reading, but it's like you want all the details. You want to, because you can't just jump into something and say, well, we'll just see if this works. Because this is a big life change. Now, there is a feeling of life purpose. Like, this is the thing that you've been waiting for. But I think you're coming at it smart. You're coming at it in an earth sort of way. So, being logical. You know, and as far as charity goes, with Four of Pentacles and the Three of Wands, I mean, it could be in terms of, you know, money to put into this, or the level of your investment. You have to be careful. You have to be careful, especially this is something you've learned. You know, going forward, you need to be careful with your money, and you don't have it to just, you know, you have to think about not just today, but your future. And that is probably what you have been thinking about. So, Nine of Cups, interesting. Two of Swords, the Chariot, and the Devil. I feel like you really want to do this, and mainly it may be because you feel stuck at where you are right now. And you're just not sure that this is the thing. And oh, the World, the Ace of Wands. This is really going to require, this is going to be risky for you, Sag. And that's where you come into the issue. It's going to be risky for you. It's a chance, it's a risk. You feel very inspired by it. But there's kind of this feeling like I've tried things before to only wind up with more problems, right? To only wind up with more problems and having to walk away because it didn't work. And so that may be something that you're considering. Seven of Cups, Queen of Wands, okay. Three of Pentacles. I feel like, too, also, you want to make sure, like this other person specifically, it could be two people. It could be a Page of Pentacles and a Page of Cups coming to you with this idea, because with the Three of Pentacles, it would say it's more than one person. And so you want to make sure, though, that they're in it for the long haul, you know, because that's one thing that's going to affect your choice. Because I feel like whoever this is, they may come off kind of flighty to you. And you want to make sure you're like Queen of Wands. You know what? I will take a risk, but I'm not sure that you are in it for the, because with the Knight of Pentacles, it would say that this is something that will take time. And you want to make sure that these people are in it, and they're in it in an equal way. Like, because this is definitely a collaboration with the Three of Pentacles. Everyone has to work together. And I feel like there might be some question too, whether all the parties can work together and whether they'd be committed. And that's something you're not sure of. Because it would, like, I really think too that this is a lot for you to think about, because definitely there's a lot that has to do with your own security. And it's like, because when you do things, you do them the whole way, right? And, you know, this is something very different. I will say that it feels like it's something very different. Because with the Hierophant and the Six of Swords, that's like throwing out old ideas, right? And I just feel like you really have to think about it. Okay? Because this will totally change your life. And one thing that I feel like you may also be telling whoever else is involved to really think about it, and what's your plan? What's your plan here? Ooh, the Empress, the King of Cups, the Four of Cups. You know what I think? I think that I mean, I feel like you're very inspired by this idea, but I think that you want to rework the plan. You want, and I feel like you're telling this person or these people this, I don't like your plan. Let's rework the plan. let's go back to the drawing board. Yeah, because the death card, the two of wands, very much so. And the emperor. Oh, very interesting. Because I feel like in this, Sagittarius, you are the emperor and the empress. You want to make sure that this can go somewhere, that this can build. What's the outcome here? So this is not about love at all, you guys. Six of Wands, Nine of Swords, and I feel like that's like Ten of Swords. Wow. I feel like there may be a lot of trouble getting these other people to pay attention to what you're saying. Because they may be taking it as just a rejection. Oh, but you're showing them. Ten of Wands. Six of Cups. I feel like what you're showing them is this can work, you know, and they, especially in the argument, they seem to be making it more about more than what it is you're saying. Knight of Swords, so there will be a lot of communication, and you know. People, it's kind of like you have to show them. And that's maybe what's happening after everybody cools off. Because there's definitely something heated going on here. Anything else? Yeah, Queen, gosh, Queen of Swords and King of Swords. But it may take a lot to make them listen to you because they're in Knight of Swords energy. You know, it's like do or die with them. We have to do this right now. And you're telling them, so down, we need a plan, which inevitably like causes discord, right? But eventually, you come back together to talk about things. Wow, Five of Wands, Jesus. Nope, the Sun. Okay. So it does work out because, you know, they are able to see things clearly. And here we go. Three of Cups. The Tower, okay. Two of Cups. So this definitely does come together and you're able to get on the same page. But I will tell you that there's an argument first. There's an argument first, Sagittarius. Also feels like you may be older than this person because it like their energy kind of feels a little immature to me. You know, they're not. It's so funny, Sag. You're the voice of reason here. You're the voice of reason. And it's like when you start having these questions, like they think it's an automatic no. But you're saying, look, let's go through the details. Okay. Okay, Sag. So let's see what you need to focus on. I will tell you this, Sagittarius. We don't make major life decisions during Mercury retrograde. Just saying. And if you do, and this feels very Mercury-ish in terms of, you know, look at the fine print. Okay. So what does Sagittarius need to focus on? What does Sagittarius need to focus on? Retreat, take a step back, Sag. Like, don't over talk this. Don't, you know, like, don't continue on with the argument to try and get the other side to see your point of view. Know when to just take a step back. Determination, you know where you are going and you will get there. Yeah. It's kind of telling you that people will come around. So let's get your... Let's get your mantra. And it's so funny because, like, on the other person's side or other people, it feels like they allow themselves to get in their feelings. Like, they're not being practical. What's the mantra of the day? The mantra of the day. I am willing to see my sameness with others. This opens my awareness to oneness. So you're definitely going to need understanding and patience here, Sagittarius, for sure, for sure. So Sagittarius, I'm so grateful you came. Thank you so much, and I hope you have the best day ever, Toodles.